Welcome to Betty's Kitchen. Today we're making candied yams. And you've probably noticed the last few uploads have been related to holidays, in particular Thanksgiving. In Betty's Kitchen, we also have yams or sweet potatoes. If you want to look them up from last year or the year before, you'll find a baked sweet potato. You'll find sweet potatoes with a pecan topping. It has brown sugar, pecan, it's all really good like that. And we also have one that has marshmallow topping. So I wanted to do something different, and this is the candied sweet potato. To start it, you need 3 or 4 medium-sized potatoes, sweet potatoes. And these are the red variety, and they happen to be very large, except for this one right here. And I've just started them boiling, and what I have is a fork right here, so I can come along and check on it. This one is just stiff as can be. This one actually has begun to get a little tender, so they may come up at different times. But what you need to do, instead of going by a time like 20 minutes or 30 minutes or 45 minutes, just test with your fork and take them out as they're done. Now what we're going to do with these sweet potatoes when they're done is to peel them, because they are being cooked here with the peelings on. We're going to peel them, and then we're going to slice them crosswise. Now you could do lengthwise, some recipes call for that, but if your sweet potatoes are huge like these, I don't think it works out very well. So we're just going to go with crosswise. You'll see that in a minute. I got the sweet potatoes out of the boiling water as they were tender, and that was like at 4 different times because there were 4 potatoes. Anywhere from 20 to 30 minutes on the first one, up to almost an hour for the really large one. And what you can do once you get them out is let them cool just a little bit, because they're too hard to handle. But if you just work on the skins a little bit, those slip off really easily. They don't have to be actually peeled. I did cut into that. But you'll notice from my display over here where I've been working on them that some of that good outer part is still there. Otherwise, it would have been peeled off if I hadn't just skinned them after they were cooked. So I'm working on this last one, trying to get it so we can cut it up. And we'll just kind of let that go. There's a little bit left there. But then just slice them about like that. And I was holding these over my baking dish, so I didn't have to transfer them. I'll just move that a little closer, and we'll get a few more sliced. You can see they're steaming, so it's not that easy to handle. But just get them spread out in your baking dish. Try to get them fairly even from end to end. And if you need to stack them, of course, that's fine. And I think I will do this other one, but first I want to show you how to mix up a little sauce that we're going to put over them. And you can use as many of these potatoes as you want. If you want to use all 4, you might want to increase the ingredients for the sauce a little bit. You need a small bowl, and then you're going to put 2/3 of a cup of brown sugar. This is firmly packed brown sugar, 2/3 of a cup. And then 1/4 cup of water goes in. And we have 1/2 stick of melted butter. That's the same as 1/4 cup. And then a little bit of seasoning here. This is 1/4 teaspoon of salt. And we have 1/4 teaspoon of cinnamon. That's optional. If you don't want to put that flavoring in, you may leave that out. It will still be good and sugary and buttery. And these are just the greatest flavors in the world to go over the top of sweet potatoes. So when you get these mixed together, you will just be putting them over the top. You can spoon them or pour them. I still have a half potato to go, so I'm not going to do the whole thing, but you get the idea. What's going to happen after I finish the other potato and getting the topping on, I'm going to put it in a 350 degree oven and I will bake it until it's nice and bubbly, and it will just have the look of being done. And I'll show you what it looks like then. Here are our candied sweet potatoes, straight from the oven. And this is a traditional Thanksgiving dish where we live, or in the South in particular. One thing you can do is cook it like I have for 20 minutes at 350 degrees. That is if the pieces are already pretty soft when you put them in. If you don't cook them that much before you put them in, then this can be in the oven for up to an hour. And it does soak up a lot of that good sauce. Something you can do is to serve them just as is, or you can take a bowl such as this and take the individual pieces and stack them and then get all of that sauce and pour it over the top. That way it will sort of sit in the sauce and absorb more of it. So give me a minute and I'll get all of these dipped out and show you an alternate way of serving them. And here's what your candied sweet potatoes will look like if you serve them in a bowl like this after you've baked them in a casserole dish. And that gives you an opportunity to redistribute the sauce, and each piece gets plenty of sauce. I'm going to take a bite of this. I can't wait because I love sweet potatoes. I have to say, Rick doesn't like them that much, and we don't have them that often because it's not really fun to have it for one person. But just got a couple here. We'll see how this tastes. These are really tender because I got them very tender on the stove before they went in the oven. And they have strings like that. That's just part of the outside of the potato. Don't worry about it. It's really good. And I took a second bite. I read a comment one time where someone said, it must have been really good because she took two bites. I think it's a two-bite recipe. Hope you enjoy it.